once more to open up your Bible. Oh my God, you know, God is so good, so faithful, so loving. If it were not for him, I wouldn't be able to make it. I wouldn't be able to do this. But I thank you that even in sometimes when it seems like there's no way, he makes a way, right? So I've proven him over and over and over and over again. All right, so we gotta start out with our heavenly sunshine. As the sunshine comes in, then things just become different, right? All right, so we sing heavenly sunshine. Heavenly sunshine, flooding my soul with glory divine. Hallelujah, I am rejoicing, singing his praises, Jesus is mine. How are you, neighbor? How are you, neighbor? So glad to see you, that you're here again. Are you, neighbor? How are you, neighbor? I'm glad to see you, that you're here again. Heavenly sunshine, heavenly sunshine, flooding my soul with glory divine. Hallelujah, I am rejoicing, singing his praise, Jesus is mine. How are you, neighbor? So glad to see you, please come again. How are you, neighbor? I'm glad to see you, as you're here again. One more time. Heavenly sunshine, flooding my soul with glory divine. Hallelujah, I am rejoicing, singing his praise, Jesus is mine. Sunshine, yes. And you know me, if you're joining us for the first time, then well, I welcome you, and we know you're going to be blessed. My name is David Ferguson. I prefer to use my name than to say Pastor Ferguson or Elder Ferguson or any of those things, though I can use those titles. But just like David of old in the Bible, I love my name. All right, so we have time for the children. I'm gonna sing a song here. It's trying to a song my mother taught me, right? So, you know, it says, "Beautiful the little hands that fulfill the Lord's commands. Beautiful the little eyes kindled with light from the skies. It's a beautiful, beautiful are the hands that fulfill the Lord's command. Beautiful, beautiful are the eyes kindled with light from the skies." And the other verse says, "All the little feet should go," and something else with the Lord should know. I just sing with that. Let me just sing right now. Like a baby, right? Beautiful the little hands that fulfill the Lord's commands. Beautiful the little eyes kindled with light from the skies. And beautiful, beautiful are the hands that fulfill the Lord's commands. Beautiful, beautiful are the eyes kingdom of light from the skies. How about that, right? So let's try this again. Play the piano again. Beautiful the land. Singing it right, and now it's a distant memory, but it stays with me, right? Okay, let's try again. Come, 1, 2, 1, 2, yes.
Beautiful the little hand that fulfilled the Lord's command.
Beautiful the little eyes in the red light from the sky.
Thing to rehearse sometimes. I don't remember to rehearse this song, that song, and I had some problems this morning. So, yeah, I don't know if I've ever played this song before, but I played, right?
But when I was little, Mama teaching us that song, right? Teaching us that song. Oh my God. That's it. You gotta clap your tiny hands. I have another tiny song, right? Okay, let's sing. This one is more well known. I mentioned it last week, but I got mixed up with the Noah's Ark thing, right? And this one is about the wise man who built his house upon the rock. Right? Okay? How about that?
And he would smile, so.
Right.
the song. Oh, there is a story in the Bible about building a house on a rock that Jesus told in Matthew chapter 7. And he told us that a parable is a story which we can get a meaning from, somewhat different from what exactly the story is. So the story might say, well, that the man was picking apples, when in truth and in fact it meant that he was doing good deeds, you know, good things for people. But somebody might say, well, he was picking apples because apples are healthy and they're good for your free to eat, right? Okay, so it was Jesus was telling a parable, and he was telling the people about how to build your house. And in this case, when he spoke about a house, he was talking about you and me, our individual selves, and who we are and what we, the things that we will do in our lifetime. Okay, so he spoke about a house, right? A house, because to build a house, it takes a lot. As a child and you're growing up, you will maybe somewhere along the line you will see a house being built, and you will see that the first thing they had to do was to dig and lay something at the bottom, and that is called a foundation. And then after that, they will build upon it the walls, and they will afterward put on the roof, right? And there are lots of things they have to do inside, right? To put in your basin, your toilet, your sink to wash your dishes, and make your bedroom so you can go to sleep, right? And your dining room where you can, you know, sit and eat. So many things you have to do, and people build houses different ways. But what was very important for them was when they lay the foundation, because if they lay the foundation very good, then the house would be good. So this is what Jesus said, and I'm going to read Matthew chapter 7, and he says, telling the people how they should live, he said, Whosoever heareth these sayings of mine and doeth them, I will liken him unto a wise man which built his house upon a rock. And the rain descended, and the floods came, and the winds blew, and beat upon that house, and it fell not, for it was founded upon a rock. And everyone that heareth these sayings of mine, and doeth them not, shall be likened unto a foolish man, which built his house upon the sand. And the rain descended, and the floods came, and the winds blew, and beat upon that house, and it fell, and great was the fall of it. So, and it came to pass, when Jesus had ended these sayings, the people were astonished at his doctrine, for he taught them as one having authority, and not as the scribes. And surely he had authority, because he's God, the Son of God. And he said, build your house with a good foundation. And this is our foundation to build upon. This word, the word of God, this is what we build our lives upon. So we build it upon doing the things that are in the Bible, that God, and doing the things that he tells us, which we can hear with our ears, okay, and which we can even feel with our spirit, okay, what he's telling us to do. And this is what is going to make us be able to stand when bad things happen to us, and we'll be able to overcome. Truly, I know what that is like. And I had my some of it this morning too. But as I said, pray for me. My desire is to continue for the Lord. We're just going to pray right now before I even say that. Let's gonna pray. Almighty God, our gracious Abba Father, the great Yahweh who dwell between the cherubim, the Lord of hosts, your name is shine forth, let the earth of your glory. Let your glory rest upon us, your light shine out of us. He's exalted, far above the heavens, he's exalted, far above the earth. He's exalted, far above the heavens, let thy glory be above the clouds. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever, and the mighty name is Yahweh Shemah the great. Your Abba the great, El Shaddai the great, Yahweh the great, Elohim the great, Adonai the great, Hashem the great, great ever for Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ the great, unto whom he said, sit on my right hand, till I make enemies thy footstool. The Lord said, well, the strength of Zion, rule out in the midst of enemies. Thank you, Father, for your grace and your glory. Oh my God, even if when you just seem to be no way, you make a way, Abba Father. The devil is a liar this morning. Father, thank you, Abba Father. Open up your Bible. It's open this morning, Abba Father. And we thank you, Father, that you said the entrance of your word brings light. Father, here are the children who are gathered and we have this session for them. I pray that they will be edified and they will be blessed, Abba Father, and that they will know how from early as they learn these things, sometimes just wondering what these things mean. As my mother taught me this song, Lord, and as you brought it back to me in my bed, I'm saying to myself, imagine those days, I'm just wondering, what are these things? What do they mean? Well, Lord, we thank you that you are the God of the little child, and you're the God of the grown child. You're the God of the man and the woman, Abba Father, the little boy, little girl, Abba Father. You're God of the full-grown man, big, little, tall, short, whatever it might be, or whoever it might be. You're the God of all creation, Lord, Abba Father. Even you speak to even to animals. For your name's and glory, for that the whole creation belongs to you. As your word said, the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof, the world and they that dwell therein, Abba Father. So I pray you bless them, and they'll get to know you and to live for thee, Abba Father. And we pray you cause us to rise up before this time, shall go not a coming in. Grant that the purpose you have for our lives accomplishing us for time and eternity. And for thine is the kingdom and the cover on the blood of Jesus Christ, the great eternal Lamb. Cover on the almighty wings of great eternal hand. Go before us, a pillar of fire at night, a pillar of cold by day. Save us in your kingdom, and the Lord shall assure us your coming glory. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. In the mighty name of Yeshua, the great eternal Lord. Amen. 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 All right. You know, the song I'm going to sing here now, one more, a couple more songs for children here.
Yeah, black and white, they are precious in its
right, all right. Amen, amen. And that's true. Jesus loves the little children of the world. Amen. Hallelujah. Okay, so let's sing our song. We want everybody to know, right? And to know that he's got the whole world in his hand, right? We can't stop singing that.